Hi friends, welcome back to BankExamsToday.com. In this video, we are going to give you a detailed information about cheques, types of cheques and crossing of the cheques. So let's start. Cheque. A cheque is a kind of bill of exchange or an unconditional order in writing addressed by the customer with a signature to the bank to pay a certain amount to the bearer or as per order. So what is bill of exchange? It is written and signed order directing the person named in it to pay a certain amount of money only to or to the order of a certain person or to the bearer. There are basically three parties to the cheque. The first one is a drawer. A drawer is a person who signs the cheque and order for the payment. The second one is drawee. A drawee, which is always a bank on which the cheque is withdrawn and ordered to pay certain amount mentioned on the cheque. And the last one is the payee, to whom the cheque is payable. Now we move to the different kinds of cheques. The first one is the open cheque. Open cheque is an uncrossed cheque which is payable at the counter of the bank, and it can be a bearer cheque or an order cheque. A bearer cheque. When a cheque is payable to a person whose name appears on the cheque or to the bearer, for example, to the person who presents the cheque to the bank for the encashment is called the bearer cheque. It can be transferred by mail delivery and do not need endorsement. And second one is the order cheque, and that is the second type of open cheque. When a cheque is payable to the person named in the cheque or to his order is called the order cheque. When the word bearer is cancelled, the cheque becomes the order cheque. It can be transferred only by the endorsement and delivery. So the person need to make a signature and need to mention to whomever the money to be paid. So that is called the endorsement. The second type of cheque is cross cheque. It is a cheque in which two parallel transfer lines are drawn across the top left with or without the words like and company, not negotiable, account pay. It cannot be encashed at the counter of the bank and can only be credited to the account of the payee. And the third and the last type of cheque is the stale cheque. A stale cheque is valid only for 3 months. If the cheque is not presented within 3 months, it got expired and becomes stale cheque or outdated cheque. Earlier the validity of cheque was 6 months, it has been reduced to 3 months with effect from 1st of April 2012. Antedated cheques. Antedated cheques contains a date on which it is drawn. If it bears a prior date or back date, it is called antedated cheque. Bank will honor this cheque until it exceeds 3 months or it becomes a stale cheque. Post-dated cheques. Post-dated cheque bears the date later than the date on which the cheque is drawn. It is called post-dated cheque. This cheque cannot be honored before the date written on it. The last one is mutilated cheque. A mutilated cheque is a cheque which is torn into pieces and it is not acceptable by the bank. Now we come to our next point, which is crossing of the cheque, which means to draw two lines, two transverse parallel lines on the left corner of the cheques. It directs a bank to deposit money strictly into the account of the payee and not to pay cash at the counter. There are different modes of crossing the cheques, like general crossing. When a cheque bears two transverse parallel lines at the left of its top corner, with the words such as and company or any other abbreviation such as and company may be written between these two parallel lines either with or without the word not negotiable is called general crossing. In this type of crossing, payment can be paid through bank account only and should not be made at the counter of paying the bank. Special crossing. When a cheque bears the name of the bank in between the two parallel lines, with or without the word not negotiable, is called special crossing, and the bank will pay to the banker whose name is written in between the crossing lines. In restrictive crossing or account payee crossing, the crossing of cheques is done by writing account payee or account payee only in between the crossing lines, and the payment will be credited to the account of the payee named in the cheque. When a cheque bears two special crossings, it is called double crossing. In this, second bank acts as an agent of the first collecting banker. It is made when the banker in whose favor the cheque is crossed doesn't have the branch where the cheque is paid. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to our channel, that is youtube.com/bankexamstoday. Install our Android application, that is GK Digest, and please make a comment. We love your feedback. Your feedback helps us to make better videos. Thanks a lot.